For me, the ocean provides a fertile environment in which we can rethink the ways we humans think about space, time, and even connectedness with the environment around us. Spending time on board Falkor with an interdisciplinary group of scientists has opened up my eyes to new avenues to translate this knowledge into action.
So this current Seafloor to Seabirds expedition in the Coral Sea Marine Park aims to map the seafloor at a high resolution towards the JEPCO Nippon Foundation Seabed 2030 project, and also observe magnetic anomalies that we find in the ocean basin that opened here around 90 million years ago.
And then there's a mid-ocean ridge.
So we're so familiar with the shape of the continents as they are today and the vastness of the ocean that it's sometimes hard to imagine that these features are not permanent, they're actually constantly on the move. So when continents split apart, sometimes they can leave behind microcontinents, basically piece of continental crust that is separated from the main continent, and this has happened here in this region that we're surveying. So Zealandia is this hidden continent that is just offshore the Eastern Australian margin, with New Caledonia and New Zealand being the only aerially exposed parts of it. In fact, 94% of this continent that is made of continental crust is submerged below the ocean. One really important feature in this region is the Kaitou Trough, which is the connection between the North Tasman and the South Coral Seas. And it's a really undersurveyed region, so we're hoping that with the data that we're collecting during this voyage, which is seafloor bathymetric data, but also magnetic data, that we can, first of all, find the mid-ocean ridge along which this basin opened, but then also understand the geomorphology and of all the processes that took place during the geologic history of this complex region.
In this expedition, we are mapping the ocean floor, as well as collecting magnetic data and microplastic samples. This information is crucial. We are actually mapping within the Coral Sea Marine Protected Area, and knowing or gaining this kind of knowledge is vital for making more informed decisions when it comes to management and understand the human impacts on these environments.